Welcome to the voice of Smolviansk, the only free, indie, heterosexual media outlet in Southwest Russia. Today I'm with Rabbi Perez here in Coney Island. Welcome, Rabbi Perez.
Thank you.
I just want to ask you a few questions. What is a goy?
A goy is a Gentile Jew. Very relaxed, very mellow, gentle Jew.
Gentile. I got it. And if you could be a goy, if you could be a Gentile, who would you want to be?
If I could be a goy, I would want to be, Howard Stern.
Okay. Well, let me ask you this. Since you are a rabbi, tell me the truth, because in our community, I've heard that the reason that the Jewish people are circumcised is because they want to get a quarter off. Is that true?
Wow, they want to get a quarter off? No, the way I see it is, the way they are, they want to get a dollar and a half off all the time. So, that's the case. Forget about it. They would have had the whole thing cut off.
All right. Now, is there really a significance for Passover, or in actuality, was it a holiday that was designed by rabbi manufacturers to produce the worst tasting food and get the most amount of money for it?
I think you're absolutely correct about that. That's the worst tasting food.
Fantastic.
I wouldn't go near that food. Forget about it.
Okay, and what was the reason that the Jews in biblical times were wandering in the desert for 40 years? In our community, we have a tradition. It's because somebody dropped the coin. Is there any truth to that?
No, I think it's because the Egyptians chased them out. I know a little bit of history. The Egyptians chased them out. I think it was called the, what was it called? The Purge?
Exodus.
Who knows? The Exodus. There you go.
All right. And what's your opinion about the UN resolution that allows any occupied nation to resist the occupying force? Meaning, legally, according to international law, Hamas would have the right to resist the Israeli oppression. What is your, you are a rabbi.
Well, that's a serious issue, so I have to give a serious answer. I'm opposed to that.
Okay. 100%. All right.
There's some dictators out there that we have to stop, and you have to go in and do what you got to do, and they shouldn't be able to do anything, these left-wing organizations.
Yeah. Okay, fantastic. Now, I just have a few more questions, and I thank you again for your time, Rabbi. Could we draw a fair and balanced comparison between the fictional character of William Shakespeare's Shylock and Bernie Madoff, Ben Bernanke, and Alan Greenspan?
Couldn't tell you who the first one was, but all I know is Bernie Madoff and Greenspan. But the other one I can't tell you about, so I have no answer for that.
That's honest enough. Who's your favorite non-Jewish media emperor?
Non-Jewish media what?
Emperor?
Non-Jewish media emperor has to be Geraldo Rivera.
Okay, very good. And did you ever eat pork?
Years ago I used to report back in Vietnam when I was, in Panton. We used to report, during the second tour of the war. Well, that was years ago, though.
Okay.
Who knows anymore?
Now, let me ask you this. When you pass a Cuban restaurant, you smell that pork belly sauté. Does it arouse your taste buds?
Oh, forget about it. The pork belly sauté. We used to eat that in Nam. We used to kill the pigs, got them right then and there. We used to eat them raw, like sushi. Like, we eat sushi out here, we used to eat raw.
Okay.
So that's nothing, the Cuban style.
And let me ask you this. What'd you do with the money?
The money from what?
The money that your mother gave you for the yarmulke.
Oh, the money's all saved up, like the Jews. I save every penny I got. Great. I got thousands, hundreds of thousands.
Rabbi, thank you so much. Zay gazon. I appreciate it, guys. Take care. Cheers, bro. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.